Hello. Welcome to Chronic Kidney Disease Program at University of California, San Diego. My name is Danuta Trzebinska, and I'm a nephrologist in our clinic. In this module, we are going to talk about the different stages of chronic kidney disease. Chronic kidney disease is quite common. It affects 11% of US population, which translates to about 30 million people. Another 30 million people are at risk for developing CKD at some point in their lives. Ideally, we would like to prevent individuals from developing CKD in the first place. But unfortunately, that is not always possible. Early detection is the second best option in order to take appropriate actions to slow down the decline of kidney function. Let's talk about estimating kidney function. It's usually not as precise or easy as checking your weight or even measuring electrolyte levels in your blood. Doctors, nurses, pharmacists use special equations to estimate kidney function based on the level of creatinine in the blood. What is creatinine? Well, creatinine is a waste product generated by muscle metabolism and removed, or excreted, if you will, from the body by kidneys. The higher the creatinine level in the blood, the less efficient kidneys are at removing it from the body, so the worse the level of kidney function is. The term for the level of kidney function is glomerular filtration rate, or GFR. GFR is the rate at which kidneys filter toxins from the blood. This number also correlates with overall kidney function. We stage kidney disease or assign severity based on the GFR. It is extremely important that you know your GFR. In simple terms, you can think of GFR as a percentage of normal kidney function. For example, GFR 40 means that your overall kidney function, yes, for both kidneys, is about 40% of normal. Please remember, it is just an estimate and not a true measure of your kidney function. Also, you need to realize that GFR fluctuates from day to day, just like your blood pressure does or stock market does. So we look at the trend and not necessarily every individual value. We'll now go over stages of chronic kidney disease. There are five of them, with one being the least severe and five being the most severe. In stage one, chronic kidney disease, GFR is relatively preserved, greater than 90, so it's considered normal or close to normal, yet there are some other markers of kidney disease. For example, there's protein in the urine, and we'll talk more about this a little bit later. So that's stage one chronic kidney disease. In stage two CKD, GFR is mildly reduced to between 60 and 89, and there are some other markers of kidney injury. Most of the time, it's protein again. You will see that protein is important. Now, stage three, this is the middle road kidney disease, and also the most common category. GFR in CKD3 is moderately reduced, is between 30 and 59. So not normal, but not so bad. At this stage, you may begin to see complications of chronic kidney disease. Now let's move to stage four. In stage four CKD, GFR is between 15 and 29. This is considered a pretty advanced stage. So we start talking about what the kidney's future might hold. We might discuss potential plans for either dialysis or transplantation or both, whatever is most appropriate for you. In stage five, GFR is less than 15. Being in stage five does not automatically mean that you need to start dialysis. Some patients can remain in stage 5 for quite a few years without requiring dialysis. In general, we do not start patients on dialysis even one day sooner than it is necessary. And most of the time, patients tell me when it is necessary. They feel it, they can tell. It is important to realize that dialysis is just a tip of the iceberg. Chronic kidney disease is a prevalent yet silent disease. Most patients do not know that they have it, since CKD is not associated with clear symptoms till this disease is quite advanced. Therefore, it is important to screen patients at increased risk for developing chronic kidney disease. Let's do two questions to test your understanding of this module. The first question is, what is GFR? That's an easy one. And the answer is, GFR is a glomerular filtration rate, which is the rate at which the kidneys filter toxins from the blood, and it is an estimation of overall kidney function. What is the most common stage of chronic kidney disease? Remember, there are 5 stages of chronic kidney disease, and the question is, which one is most common? The correct answer is stage 3 is the most common stage of chronic kidney disease. Congratulations! At this point, you have completed the module on the stages of chronic kidney disease. Please check our website for additional educational modules on kidney health.